Over the years, as far as reggae music is concerned, we basically see that it's been one artist at a time, for the most part, where you have one artist who does exceptionally well and breaks away from the pack, you know what I mean? Right now, what we're really working toward is the whole pack breaking out. We want to see multiple artists on Billboard and, you know what I mean, on the charts, you know what I mean, whereas reggae music is concerned. So it will keep it open for all of us as reggae musicians, keep, you know, bringing our culture to different people and keep people interested in what we're doing, you know, as opposed to just what one person is doing, you know what I mean? So that is definitely something that we're working toward right now, is to really have that kind of acceptance for reggae music, you know? You know, a lot of the topics and issues that we deal with are a little bit, yes, you know, hard to swallow, you know what I mean? It's not just a club music and party music, so some of it is very opinionated. So I guess that you know, at times, that make it difficult for us to get through, you know, easily, in a certain sense. But, you know, again, that is what is important about music and what makes the music special. The world has always had troubles, you know what I mean? And we see that a lot of things are escalating now, both good and bad, because meanwhile you have a lot of wars and things escalating, you still have a lot of people waking up, people, you know, willing to take action and speak out for themselves, you know what I mean? So it's an interesting time right now, and you know, reggae music has always been known for speaking out. It's always been a voice for people who think are voiceless, you know what I mean? So it's definitely time for that kind of music and that kind of vibration. Sending messages for me is very important. Really just because of the kind of person that I am still, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, the kind of things that we speak about in our songs is the kind of things that we also speak about even in day-to-day, you know, speak about issues that are going on and how we feel about it. So, you know, really, we just love to express ourselves through music, truly, you know what I mean? And say what's on our mind, you know what I mean? And like I said again, knowing that music is such a great tool of communication, and knowing to that, really helped to influence the younger generation coming up also, because I remember when, you know, I was in high school, the kind of music that I would listen to is how I would move, you know what I mean? So I know that it, when it comes out to young people, music is very influential. So in that sense, we feel like, you know, we have a responsibility. Well, the album itself really has a lot of different musical influences involved in it, you know what I mean? When you listen to the album, you'll hear, like you say, you know, hip-hop influences, you'll hear R&B influences, you know what I mean? We'll have some classical influences. So that is one thing, it's palatable to a lot of different, you know, genres of music, people who like different genres of music, you know what I mean? And again, to a lot of the topics, I guess, that are on the album is very universal. It relates to a lot of people. Ghetto Youths is a label that was started by Steve and Ziggy, my two elder brothers, you know what I mean? Which was really that they could do things and not really interfere with the day-to-day runnings of Tough Club. You know, and over the years, we as brothers have really embraced that label and built upon it. That now it has become something more serious than just a hobby label. So now we've, you know, we're one with Tough Gang, so it's Tough Gang Ghetto Youths. And we all move together as a family, you know what I mean, as a team, really. You know what I mean, for me it's great because I have a lot of experience to draw from. A lot of elders who have been doing what I'm doing, you know, years before me, so I can learn a lot from them. My brother Steve is being a producer, you know what I mean, so it's that same relationship that you've had from when you were just, you know, learning to do play ball and these things, you know what I mean? It's that same kind of relationship you carry over into the studio, where you have an older brother who is a mentor, who you can know that is true to you, you know what I mean? He's really care for you and know what you like, you know what he like, you know what I mean? So it works great that way. And as for us though, I mean, we have a lot of studios and stuff like that in our homes. So when it comes out to music, it's not really so much a thing that you have to think about too hard, you know what I mean? It's kind of something that we do as a part of our lifestyle, basically, you know?